A very good morning to all HPAS aspirants and abhipedia users. We are live at Abhimanyu Chandigarh Center, and today the topic for discussion is HP art and culture. This topic carries quite a considerable weightage in both prelims and mains, but today's lecture we will be only focusing on the pre part, because the pre is approaching and amid all the uncertainties which are going on, and there is a panic mode going on whether the exam will be on time or not. As of now, you should stay calm and just focus on your preparation and make sure you are utilizing your best time and not being distracted by unnecessary rumor, because rumor mongering start whenever such pandemics are outbreaking. So we should stay calm and focus on our task. So if you are hearing my audio clear, kindly just say a yes so that I could start the lecture straight away. Is the screen visible? Can you see the paintings clearly? The PPT is visible. And if you could see the, I hope, yes, Tribhuvan, Anirudh Thakur, all others who have joined or participated actively in our last lectures on HP, biodiversity and budget are here. You could just type good morning or a yes so that I can start the lecture. So, okay. So let's start with our session, because we have limited time, and I'll be starting with the most difficult part, that's the painting part, because there are two difficulties which students are currently facing when they are preparing this section of HP art and culture. First, they don't get the requisite source, because in the traditional books, whether you are following Know Your State or the HP Dreamland or Wonderland, there is no concrete or concise material which is available for pre point of view. They have elaborated discussions going on that who patronized the painting or what were the major themes, but in pre point of view there are four distinct themes on which questions can be framed. So first, an overall view that how Indian painting has evolved. Coming to Indian paintings, there are two broad themes, either they are mural paintings or they are miniature paintings. When you are painting on a wall or a fresco, such elaborated paintings which we find in Ajanta, Ellora, these are called the mural paintings. Whereas if you are painting on a cloth or a piece of paper and the emphasis is on delicacy or the design smoothness, then it is called the miniature painting. So the first question of the day is whether Pahari paintings, which are the HP paintings we'll be discussing, are they mural paintings or the miniature paintings? So all those who have joined can type in comment section if they are confident about the theme, the mural or miniature, because we cannot err on the basic premises that if you have been avid cultural traveler, can you relate that what kind of paintings are the Pahari paintings? Since the most of the paintings are on paper or cloth, they are classified as miniature paintings. And typically Himachal didn't have a rich cultural tradition of paintings from immemorial times. It was in medieval period when you could see at the time of Humayun this miniature painting theme was being started, and there was important painters like Abdul Samad, Mir Sayyed Ali, and portrait painting was quite a major theme which was being adopted at different parts. Eventually, at the time of Aurangzeb, there was persecution of some major painters, and hill region provided a specific place where these painters could have easily been shielded. And since the rulers were quite patronizing of just giving them the shelter and giving them the patronage, so these independent centers developed, which were agglomeration of Mughal as well as Rajput paintings which were prevalent, and eventually a unique art of Pahari paintings have evolved. So this is the historical background how the Pahari paintings will come into being. So basically the 18th century is the century in which this art has prospered, and it's continuing to enrich our lives every now and then. So finally we have students who have started to join in. So make sure I will keep this session a two-way interactive one, so you could always Vikas had said, but the primarily if you have to choose one option, make sure you are choosing the miniature one theme. Coming to the Pahari paintings, there are two distinct schools which have evolved, and they are quite different from one another. Okay, and would you like to try it, Vikas, since you have joined in? What are the two basic, because one is called the Northern series, the other one is called the Southern series. Because two major distinct styles of Pahadi paintings. Okay, there is the Basholi and there is Kangra Kalam. So these two themes are the main focus area, and this one is called the Southern Series. It prospered in Jammu and Kashmir and parts of Kullu as well. Kangra prospered in the, as the name suggests, in the Kangra state. Guler was the hotbed from where this theme started, and eventually the other themes have evolved, and this is called the Nadan series. Both the schools evolved simultaneously. Eventually both have prospered in their own way. Our main focus would be the Pahadi art of Kangra, because this is on which the main classification is based on. So we have, okay, so this is a fresh start for Vikas. So Pankaj Kumar has joined. He is already our active student and he knows the Kangra art well. So I will be discussing all this. So very good morning to those who have joined. And once again, I am briefing up, since art and culture, painting is the main theme, I will be discussing them from P point of view. So make sure you have a pen and a paper ready with you, because I will be making a chart which you should ideally jot it down. Because generally, when we are just listening to the things, we may not recall. And I want you to make the best use of this lecture. So basically, whenever the examiner has to frame a question on this painting theme, he has four distinct choices on which the question can be framed. First is on basis of the art form, that on geographical extent can be asked that this painting is based on which. Since the name are based on the region itself, this is an easy question to attempt. Only there are two schools. There is Arki school, in which there might be some confusion to some student, and there is a Guler. Even though Guler, if you are from Himachal, should not pose any problem. Then the second theme on which the question might come is that who are the rulers who gave this patronage? Because we had seen that how after Aurangzeb had attacked, and there was persecution risk, lot of painters who settled there, they were given shelter by these rulers. So without their patronage, these schools might not have prospered, because this is a major significant event in cultural history, because it shows the decline of Mughal Empire and revival of Hinduism. So this is a larger significance as well. So you cannot miss the name of rulers as well. Okay? So it's preferable you just draw a table in which the first form would be the name of school, in second you can write patronized by. In the third column, there were some prominent painters. Yes, there were some prominent painters who had left their imprint on this. And Jyoti, I will coming to all this, because the final theme is based on the themes on which they are based. Okay, so basically the basic difference is the geographical extent, the number of rulers who had patronized, and then the themes are quite distinct. In this Basholi and Southern school, once again, even though in both Hinduism has dominated, there is a Rag Mala series, Ramayan, and in the Kangra state you will see the Lord Krishna and Radha theme. The love of the Lord Krishna and Radha has been epitomized in a graceful manner, and yes, the portraits are also there. And one key theme which you will see in Nadan series is the landscape. The landscapes have been defined quite distinctly, and even the animals like the cattle which they are drawing is quite delicate and finely balanced. They are almost lifelike. So the current painting which you are seeing is from the Nadan series only. You could see there is a specific details given to the cattle as well as the iconic figures, and you could see the landscape as well. So such themes are what are in the Nadan themes, and I will be going into the specifics as well. So I hope everyone has by now drawn the all four themes. First is art form, the second is the patronized by, third is the painters, and then you have the basic theme. So this journey of our main focus would be on the Himachal Pahadi school. So you could start with the Guler, right? In the first school which we are covering is the Guler. It was asked in UPSC once in mains as well. They had shown that Krishna playing flute is quite dominant in Indian art and culture. So where this has evolved. So this is where such themes have evolved. So Guler is the main form. Any one of you who had already prepared the topic, can you name the ruler or the specific painters who were emerged from this Guler school of painting? Because this is the major school. Guler will set the base for Kangra. It is called, this is another question, that which school is known as the pre-Kangra art or cradle for the Kangra. Any idea? All are starting afresh today. any student who has previously appeared in this examination and has some fair idea. Okay, no one. So let's start then. First of all, you have to understand there was two patrons of the Gulair paintings, right? Govardhan Singh. Okay, he was the main ruler who has the taste in the paintings, and he got patronized. So you can write Govardhan Singh. And there was also another ruler, and Daleep Singh, Raja Daleep Singh. So you could mention any of the two names in the first category. So these two names have to be memorized, because these were the two rulers who set the base. And the main painters were Manku and Nansuk, M-A-N-A-K-U, Manku and Nansuk. So make sure you could create a small mnemonic for yourself. Nan means I, Man means the mind. So it's easy to memorize. So these were the two painters who just set the base or foundation. From here on, the journey eventually evolved. So Manku and Nansuk were the main painters. Now the theme here is the women portraits were painted with delicacy. So you could say the women painters, and that's what the specialty is. And the two portraits which are still remembered are of ruler himself. So you could mention the portrait of Daleep Singh and his son Bhishan Singh. So portrait of Bhishan Singh, if they ask, or portrait of Daleep Singh, you have to associate them with the Gulair art. Because generally either the painting theme or the ruler, or this would be asked, so we should be convenient with them. So this art form prospered for a few years, and eventually with the death of Govardhan Singh. So there was another ruler who emerged on the scene, and he was a great patron of art. And that's where the Kangra school, the main school, comes into play. So right, the second school, the Kangra school. So Kangra one is the most famous, if you could recall the ruler, because I'm sure all of you must be knowing, because there is one ruler who is remembered in all Himachal for patronizing art and painting, and he's from Kangra only. So just write down the name, because I'm sure you must be knowing. You could try even if it's wrong. There's a famous ruler from Kangra who epitomized this art, because eventually this Kangra Northern school, which we are saying, prospered under him. Easy name, not a difficult name, because we have quite a students who have already joined. There must be someone who must be knowing. Yes, Jyoti and Madhu Sharma, both have answered it correctly. It's Sansarjan. So make sure it counts in an easy theme. Because if you will read the personalities part chapter, or you will read the Kangra history, or you will read the cultural part, in all these themes, the name of Sansarchand is clearly highlighted. So we have the right answer. So make sure this Sansarchand chapter you just go through in detail, because this is always counted in an easy part. Now you have to understand coming to the famous painters part, there are three names which are prominent. You could just jot them down. There is Fattu, F-A-T-T-U, Parkhu, P-A-R-K-H-U, and there is Kushan Lal. Okay, so name once again are not easy to memorize, but once again, and some mnemonic could be created, and try jotting down. There is Fattu, Parkhu, Kushan Lal. There was Manku and Nansuk in the Gulair art. Fattu, Parkhu and Kushan are in the Kangra Kalam. And there is a one specific place in which the most of the works of these iconic painters have been preserved. It was Surajpur Tira. And you have to understand, due to Kangra earthquake, lot of work has been destroyed. And that was the decline of Kangra as well. So you could mention that place in the theme as well. S-U-R-A-J-P-U-R, Tira. T-I-R, cradle of Kangra art. This could come that which is known as the cradle of Kangra art. If they ask you precursor, then it's Gulair. If they ask you cradle, then it's the Surajpur Tira. And in theme, you would like highlight that since the Radha Krishnan theme is the most prominent one, as you could see in the screen. This is of Kangra art only. So you have to highlight Jayadev's Geet Govind. Okay, mentioned is in this theme, Jayadev's Geet Govind. There is another theme which you could highlight is of the Bihari Satsaiya, S-A-T-S-A-I-Y-A, Bihari Satsaiya. And Bhagavat Puran themes have also been highlighted. So make sure these three themes are the ones on which you should mention. So this is what the main two schools are, Gulair and Kangra. Now let's cover the other schools as well. The third school which we have to cover is the Chamba. So Chamba, if anyone having a fair idea, who are the two rulers under whom, because we are talking about 17th to 18th century in which these themes have prospered. So if you could recall any major ruler under Chamba or some painter, if you had prepared, or you could have used your book as well. If you have your Himalayan Dreamland, Know Your State, or Mia Govardhan, you could even open this chapter so that you could compare few facts as well. So here, once again, there are two rulers. Just jot them down. I think no one is knowing them. Yes, finally, we have one more answer. So just write them. There is Raja Prithvi Singh and Raja Uday Singh. Okay, these are the two, Prithvi and Uday. Okay, so Raja Uday Singh and Raja Prithvi Singh. And the painter which we have to memorize is an easy name. Once again, you can see the name of painters are quite short. There is Fattu, there was Parkhu, there was Nansuk. Now the another name is just Nikka. Okay, the small, there is Nikka name. And the key characteristic of Chamba painting is quite different. You would see that the painters have a square base of the faces. When they are drawing the painting, they are characterized by a strong jawline, and that's the distinguishing feature which makes it from the other schools of art. Yes, the themes are still the same only, and which have been asked, and then you have to, then you could write the Vishnu incarnations, because there is some technical snag. I'm not able to get the theme. Just write the Vishnu incarnations in the theme part. Apart from that, we have another school which is Kullu. Okay. Kullu once again is closely associated with the first school which we had highlighted, the Basholi. And in Kullu, Raja Jagat Singh is to be enumerated. Okay? So, Kullu with the Jagat Singh. There is no specific name which has emerged in this school. So, we will have to keep that column blank. Yes, you could go through your sources. If you get any specific name, there is no harm in adding. But currently, that specific name is not critically is mentioned. So, we are keeping that column blank. And the key themes on which the paintings have been created in the this Kullu school is Ramayana. Specific Kands like the Bal Kand, Lanka Kand, Aranyaka Kand. So make sure just you write two or three Kand, Ayodhya Kand, Lanka Kand, Bal Kand. So anything related with Ramayana is more gracefully depicted in this Kullu art, because this was the theme Bhagavatism was being, and there is a Bhagavat Puran as well being highlighted in this school. But the main themes are centralized towards Ramayana. And the one distinctive feature which separates it from Chamba school is that unlike the square jaws, there are prominent chins and the eyes are quite wide. When they are creating, the eyes of the portraits are quite iconic. So that's what makes them the interesting one. So you could write prominent eyes and square base. Then the next school is Arki. In Arki school, you have to understand this is in currently, it falls under the Solan district, present day Arki. Otherwise, it was at that time in the related to the Shimla. There is a specific province, Bagal state. If you will read the ancient history, it's there itself. So, in theme, you could write the Bagal state. And then the themes which are to be highlighted are Shiv Parvati and Krishna legend. Okay, Shiv Parvati and Krishna legend, because these are the main themes which have been highlighted. And you have to understand, after death of Sansar Chand, the main painter Fattu had migrated in Arki. So the name remains once again the same, Fattu and the Hastu. Okay, so these are the main painters associated with the Arki school of. Arki is quite a different one. Once again, it falls under the same Nadan series only. And finally, we have the last school, the Mandi. Okay. In Mandi school, you have to understand there was Raja Sidh Sen. So, in ruler's column, you could write Sidh Sen, S-I-D-H-S-E-N, Sidh Sen. And the painters, once again, names are tough one. There is Sanju and Muhammadi, S-A-N-J-N-U, Sajnu and Mohammadi, M-O-H. So one is a Muslim name, one is quite like a Hindi name. Okay. So all of those who are answering, Nikka from Chamba and Johnny Girl from Chamba, all are going right in the direction. So this was the main theme. And one thing in characteristic feature you would like, that in previous theme we had seen that there was so much emphasis on the short chin as well as on the broad eyes. Here you will see a large head, large feet and hands. So these are the specific type of paintings which have developed independently in the Mandi district. So that makes them quite different from it. So once again, if you are not able to memorize the theme part, say in prelims, that's perfectly acceptable, because generally the factual part of the painters and the patronization by the various rulers is being asked. But still you should at least the broader theme of Geet Govind, Jayadevs, Ragmala, and Bhagavat Puran, these are the prominent ones. And more or less the eternal love of Lord Krishna and are being celebrated in a very graceful manner. So these are what the various painting schools are about. So make sure, if you want to add Bilaspur and other schools, Noorpur, that's your choice. Noorpur is more closely related to, once again, the Basholi one. And there is strong semi-Mughal influence in the remaining schools. So these are the some of the main schools. Start by the Guler and Kangra. And once your rhythm starts, then it's preferable to memorize at least the Chamba and the Arki one as well. Because these four schools are the ones on which the questions can be there is Admit school as well. So these are because this Himachal Pradesh, as Pankaj has highlighted, there are 38 different centers of this Pahari art which have evolved. So it's not possible for us to highlight each and every specific one, but still it's your journey. And in mains, these additional schools, if you highlight, they carry quite a weightage a lot. So make sure you keep on add at least two or three major school in similar way, so that will make your preparation best one, because we have to cover other themes as well. So for the time being, the major schools of painting I'm concluding at this part. Okay, so I hope by now the chart is ready. In case you have missed, make sure after the video ends you just jot the main schools. We had covered all five or six major schools. Now the second theme which we have to cover now is an easy part, and this I am expecting more participation since all of you are from Himachal Pradesh. There are some prominent museums and art galleries where such themes have been preserved or being highlighted. And I have mentioned the four key are, there is Nagar, there is Bhuri Singh Museum, and Reta is we all famous. So I am already getting the replies. And there is Raja Meher Chand Bhup Chand. Arki school was patronized by, yes, Meher Chand we have already highlighted, and Bhup Chand is can also be added. The main patron was Meher Chand in Arki. In Mandi there was Raja Sidh Singh. So the first one is highlighted by Jyoti. It's right, the famous Bhuri Singh Museum, you have to understand, is in the Chamba street. We have seen the Chamba paintings were quite prominent one. So this school museum is in Chamba. Yes, the second one, who is going to answer the second? Yes, Jyoti has once again answered, the Nagar Art Gallery, because this is the most famous gallery of Himachal Pradesh. If you are preparing art and culture of Himachal Pradesh, this has been showcased in the depth part. And yes, all of you are answering it correctly. It's in the Kullu district. But the question does not end here, apart, because you have to go in this Nagar Art Gallery is famous for one prominent painter who created almost 7,000 artifacts. Can you name the famous, because there's a foreign name, because Kangra, that's all right. You have mentioned, you have answered the various museum and gallery correctly, but now I'm going in depth. In Nagar Art Gallery, I want the famous painter who has answered, because Madhu, Arpit, all are answering correctly. Yes, the Arpit has answered and Johnny Gerg has answered it. It's the Nicholas Roerich. So this is the institute, even there is a Himalayan Roerich Institute which is dedicated to his work. And he was one of the painters which was not only famous in the hill state, even the leaders like towering personalities like Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Indira Gandhi, both have even highlighted his work. And Indira Gandhi once said that his work depicts the spirit of Himalayas. And Even the our culture, and Jawaharlal Nehru has said that his work is a testament of a spiritual culture which is not only of present generation, which will stand test of time as well. So because the delicacy with which he has painted the landscape is magnanimous. So we will come into their major works as well. So this is good to see that you know about Nicholas Rorich, or of you who have just joined in. So in Nagar Art Gallery, apart from Kullu, you could highlight Nicholas Rorich word. Okay, and the spellings are as you have seen comment section, so we will not waste our time on typing that. And you mentioned about Himalayan Rorich Institute as well. In local language, Uruswati is the name given to it. Okay, so, and this meant local language, so it meant morning starlight. Okay, morning star. So they might ask that Uruswati is associated with, or Himalayan Rorich Institute is associated with the work of. So make sure you are able to decode question whether it's from personality point of view or from the place point of view. Place part, I guess all of you are in preparation mode. You are easily decoded the Nagar art. Then Himachal Darshan photography. Can someone add, because this has not been answered, I am seeing in comment section. Himachal Darshan photo gallery, it's not as famous as Andretta or wo, but still it has preserved the journey of Himachal Pradesh evolution. So there is no harm in adding that, because match the following question. Because this was associated with the last school which we had just covered. You can give it a try. Sheila Kippert, the exact, yes, it's in Mandi district. Okay, so Himachal Darshan photo gallery, you will associate it with the last school we had covered, the Mandi one, with the Mandi. And then comes the main one, which you have already answered, Andretta Art Gallery in Kangra. Because we had seen how the Nadan paintings or the Nadan series, which was the main for, because these Kangra art paintings are famous as from Indian point of view. Whenever Pahari painting article you will read, you will find mention of Kangra Kalam. So here once again, we don't have to just limit ourselves to the location. We should know about the major works which are being displayed here. There are two famous painters who spent their majority of life here and have painted some breathtaking portraits. Can you just try? Because yes, I am getting the answers of Shimla and that Mandi. Now we are focusing on Andretta Art Gallery. Can you just highlight the two famous painters? Because if you have read the personality chapter from Himalayan Dreamland, Wonderland, there are two prominent painters who are associated with this Andretta. Nagar is with Nicholas Rorich, but Andretta is with some two more prominent names, and they are comparatively easy to memorize because they are. Yes, Arpit has once again answered, and Madhu has also answered correctly. It's the Shobha Singh. Okay, so Shobha Singh, the great painter Sardar Shobha Singh, has made some of the most iconic portraits of all times, which we see in our homes as well. They are associated with the Andretta. And the other name, can you associate the foreign name? There's another one, NR are her initials, because her works are also remember till date, Nora Richard. So add on, apart from Shobha Singh, Nora Richard as well. And the story goes like, there was E.W. Parker who had gifted the land to Nora Richards to develop a cultural center, because a need was felt that the prospering miniature painting art, which was blooming at full scale, had received a setback after that most of the painters have died, or after the Kangra Kalam there was a setback at the gallery. So numerous centers needed some impetus. So it was E.W. Parker who gifted this land, and eventually this Andretta came into, because such weird questions at times are also asked, that who gifted the land, or ask in a story format. So make sure you even write the E.W. Parker, and it was Nora Richard who started, and eventually Shobha Singh, and both names are associated with this one. So these are the four main cultural centers or the museum in which you could clearly highlight or see the main paintings of the Kangra Kalam as well as the other ones. Now let's go into the next short heading, which you can create is the famous painters and their works. Okay, so I am highlighting now the famous works, because already two times the question have appeared from this section. So there are four painters which we will be covering on. Okay, the three names we had already covered, there is Nicholas Rorich, there is, and we have Nora Richard, Sardar Shobha Singh, but we cannot just ignore the iconic works of Amrita Shergill. So let's start with her only, Amrita Shergill. So all those who have prepared, just go ahead. Can you name any famous works of Amrita Shergill? It has, one has already been asked in Himachal previous year papers. Any famous work, because she left her imprint even till date, her works are celebrated, there are articles on her life, how she was ahead of time. Yes, she was born in Hungary and practiced her main art in that. So we have Siesta, okay, some major work, because there are three or four for which she is remembered. It's given in the personality chapter as well. There's a long list, but some prominent names have to be memorized. So yes, we have got a few answers from Arpit. Okay, chalo, let's start. Probably this part you have not covered. So make sure you write them in sequence so that they are easy to memorize. Since her major work associate with the landscapes and the minutest detail of the environment, so start with the hill scene. Okay, so you could write the hill scene as her first work. Then you could mention the hill woman. Okay? And then there is a girl with a pitcher. Okay, that's another famous iconic art. There's a specific iconic painting, girl with the pitcher, and there's a woman on a charpai, okay, C-H-A-R-O-P-O-Y, woman on a charpai, and red clay elephant is also one of her famous works. So they, in typically in such question, they highlight the key painting and they associate the give the names of Shobha Singh, Nora Richard and Amrita Shergill. Or the other way around is, which of the following is not a famous work of Amrita Shergill. So this list which I have just given is not exhaustive one. These are the prominent names, because these are the first ones which have been highlighted. So hill girl, hill scene, hill woman, girl with a pitcher, woman on a charpai and red clay elephant. So these are, have to be memorized at any cost. So we are finally woman on a beach, even that is there, and self-portrait is also important that Pankaj has highlighted. So the list can be even expanded, but these one I want that you should be in position to recall. Then this name Amrita Shergill is not to be confused with Amrita Pritam. Lot of time when we are conducting interviews, when I ask students about the Amrita Shergill, Amrita Pritam, lot of students fumble. Can you just highlight what was the contribution of Amrita Pritam, why she is remembered? Because name starts with Amrita, lot of students, because that's a historical political personality. Yes, go ahead, because we have been getting responses. Because she is not related with art and culture. Amrita Pritam, famous personality, modern history, also finds her reference. Can someone just highlight the role of Amrita Pritam? Because after independence, the first health minister, woman health minister was Amrita Pritam. Okay? So make sure you are not confusing Amrita Shergill with Pritam, because at times is the first option when they are asking painting, they mention Amrita Pritam. So make sure you are able to differentiate these two. Now let's come to the Nora Richard works. Okay? Nora Richard also has left imprint, and the one of the country life was the question which was asked in Himachal Pradesh. So write the country life. There is the village play. Yes, we are finally getting. Yes, she was a writer, Rajkumari Amrit Kaur. Yes, her main, she was Rajkumari Amrit Kaur, health minister. That you can jot down. That's a separate theme. And in Nora Richard, you will write the country life, the son comes home, and the village play. At least memorize these three. And already the country life has been asked in HAS exam. So these are the three works of the Nora Richard. Then coming to Nicholas Roerich, we had seen how the Nagar Art Gallery is dedicated to works of the great Nora Richard, Nicholas Roerich. So can you give any specific name of Nicholas Roerich? Because the names are quite difficult at the moment. Any single name which you feel you could recall? Because we are getting few replies. Anyone can try if they know? Because, okay, this is a difficult one, you could jot it down. There is Drops of Life. You can make sure there is Drops of Life. Signs of Maitreya. Okay, M-A-I-T-R-E-Y-A. Then there is Banners of East. Okay, Banners of East. And there are Pearls of Striving. So you can see the philosophical angle as well. You could see the names are not as straightforward. There is a Drop of Life. There is you could say pearls of striving, signs of Maitreya, and again the banners of it. So if you see some philosophical names and which are not as usual, like we have seen the hill scene, hill woman, then you could make educated guess that this could be among the one of the works, because he has left a large legacy of the works, and it's difficult to jot down, because there are almost 20 to 30 works which are quite interesting one, which can be associated with him. Okay, so Doom City is also another one. Nora kar main repeat kar deta hu. Nora Richard ke humne teen themes likhe. Ek to hai the country life, hai na? Ek hai aapke the village play. ठीक है, तो आप देखोगे थोड़ा आपके रूरल टाइप एंगल इसमें आ रहा है, और सन कम्स होम. ठीक है, तो एक स्टोरी बन रही है, जैसे आप कह सकते हो कि एक कंट्री थी, उसमें विलेज प्ले चल रहा था, उसमें सन वापस आ गया, तो कि निमोनिक बनाओगे आप इनकी पूरी स्टोरीज को, तभी वो मेमोराइज होते हैं. जैसे उसमें तो आपके हिल थीम पकड़ लिया आपने अमृता शेरगिल में, और उसमें आप देखोगे बार बार हिल वुमेन है, हिल आपके गर्ल है, और एक वुमेन चारपाई पे बैठी हुई है, रेड क्ले एलिफेंट मूव कर रहा है. तो ऐसे इनको निमोनिक्स बना के एक स्टोरी फॉर्म में भी याद किया जा सकता है, तभी आपकी थोड़ी इसमें प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगी. हम बुद्धा द गिवर भी आपके थीम है ना. चलो वो लिस्ट आपके चलती रहेगी, हमने तीन कवर कर दिए. फाइनल हमें करना है अब सरदार शोभा सिंह. इनके वर्क्स तो काफी ईजी है मेमोराइज करने, क्योंकि इन्होंने पोर्ट्रेट पेंटिंग्स पे ज्यादा किया. तो सबसे मेजर पोर्ट्रेट इनका कौन सा रिमेंबर किया जाता है, कोई इसको कंप्लीट करना चाहे? सरदार शोभा सिंह कंपैरेटिवली इजी नेम्स हैं. क्योंकि सबसे मेजर पोर्ट्रेट जो बहुत कॉमनली आपके बार बार उसको हम यूज कर रहे हैं डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स में, काफी टॉवरिंग पर्सनैलिटी है. हाँ, जैसे कि अर्पित ने राइट आंसर फिर से किया है, सोनी महिवाल. जैसे एक तो ये वाला इनका थीम काफी फेमस है, इसी से आप स्टार्ट कर लीजिए पहले. चलो ऐसे वाले थीम लिख सकते हैं, सोनी महिवाल, ओमर ख्याम. ठीक है, तो ये भी आपकी इक्वली फेमस थीम है, जिन पे उन्होंने अपना वर्क को हाईलाइट किया है. पर जो मेन चीज आपको मेमोराइज करनी है वो है पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ गुरु नानक एंड अदर सिख गुरुज, एंड देयर इज पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ जीसस क्राइस्ट एज वेल, एंड द कांगड़ा ब्राइड. दिस हैज बीन आस्क्ड, पहले पूछा था, इसको भी आप हाईलाइट कर सकते हैं. तो कम से कम कांगड़ा ब्राइड, और ये सोनी महिवाल, ओमर ख्याम, और पोर्ट्रेट्स, पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ गुरु नानक, सिख गुरुज, एज वेल एज ऑफ क्राइस्ट, है ना. तो दीज आर मधु शर्मा, हीर रांझा, सोनी महिवाल. तो दीज वर द थीम्स विच वर एपिटमाइज बाय ग्रेट सरदार शोभा सिंह, एंड यू कुड सी देम इन द एनब्रेटा आर्ट गैलरी विच वी हैड जस्ट डिस्कस. ठीक है, सो दिस इज वॉट our the first major theme of today's lecture was paintings, and we had tried to cover it holistically. We have covered the famous personalities, we had covered the museums and art galleries, and the famous schools. Now the second theme is equally important, which is not properly given in the textbooks which we are following. So I'll be focusing on the next theme now, and we'll be starting with a basic slide which is on the temple architecture. Now temple architecture once again is a holds true, because it's the Himachal we know is a Dev Bhumi, and we cannot have a art and culture session without the description of temple architecture. This theme can even be asked in mains, so make sure you are noting the key points here. So I have started with a major picture of some of the famous temples. So can you just guess the name, because some of you must have visited by now, all of you are from Himachal. This is a famous temple of Himachal Pradesh. We will be focusing on its architecture from just on. Yes, anyone wants to give it a try, because this is quite different, because most of the temples in Himachal Pradesh have distinct architecture. Yes, Arpit has once again, it's the Hidimba temple, Vikas, Jyoti, all of you have answered. So I hope by now you have even visited this. So you could see that there is some distinct pattern which is being followed, and these are typically not there in the Himachal Pradesh state. This type of architecture is there in Nepal. Okay, so this has influence, it shows the influence that art is not limited to any geographical barrier. Wherever it is prospering, it is being accepted. So this question even has been asked in prelims, that it, in which of the following you would see this specific architectural style of Hidimba is associated with. Okay, so we have to now cover the four basic styles which are followed in temple architecture in Himachal Pradesh. Yes, anyone wants to give it a try? That its Hidimba is based on which, because this was asked in prelims in Himachal Pradesh. By now you must be have gone through the such questions. Anyone wants to give it a try? That what are the different styles of temple architecture, and this Hidimba is represents which specific style. Because you have to understand this architecture would be based on the roof style. The typical roof which is there would be asked. Yes, it's the arpithel once again, it's the pagoda. You don't have to confuse it with pyramid. Pyramid is a separate theme. Even though it appears like a pyramid, but this is called the pagoda style. Okay, so we are getting the answer. So I will highlight the all four major themes for you. Okay, so first of all, let's discuss what these terms means. And then, yes, we are all answering it correctly. So we are getting the replies. So these are the four basic themes on which you should focus while preparing for Himachal temple architecture. The first theme is a straightforward one. When there is, it is called the penthouse, the pent roof and veranda type. Okay, because since we get seen in the various districts of Himachal Pradesh, there is snow which falls. So it's always desirable that it's a pent roof type of architecture is followed. So this is a conventional style. There is no dearth of examples. There is a long list which you could memorize. In pyramidical, you will see there is an elongated structure which resembles a pyramid. So this is quite distinct style which we have, and it is rightly described as pyramid because it has the, when you look at three-dimensional view, you would see that it's quite a remarkable one. And yes, the Bajnath is Nagar style, pagoda, pent roof, all these four have been answered and you are getting it. I have already highlighted in this one. And the pagoda style we have just highlighted. There is a multiple roofs which you will see one after another, and the coiled structure becomes a dominating feature. So roof is quite a dominating feature in the pagoda style. The final style is a quite different one. It's a Satluj valley style, and you have to understand it's with fusion of two. There is a original pent roof and then you club it with the pagoda style. So when you add additional at the entrance, the pent roof, and then it is followed by some iconic roof, then it is called the Satluj Valley style. So in this, a pre-question can be asked that Satluj Valley style is combination or fusion of which two styles. So they will try to confuse you with pyramidal and pent roof or pyramidal and pagoda. So make sure you pick the pent roof, which is followed by the pagoda style. Okay. So once again, I think better we can draw a short table. In the first one, you could just highlight the name of the roof style. In second, the major example. This list will not be exhaustive one because it's a rough theme to just memorize all the temples. But the main ones I will be highlighting. When you are revising from your book, just add two more example to the list so that by elimination, you are in position to attempt, because it's not possible for you to just go into the details of each style. But broadly, if you have the image and you have visited that temple, then at least you could make an educated guess. So make sure the first one, the common hut type, is the pent roof. When it's a typical pyramidical, you will see an elongated and three-dimensional structure, which is a pyramidal shape. And the third one is the pagoda style, like the Hadimba, which we have just highlighted in the image. You could see a look at once again. So this is what the pagoda style is. And then finally, when there's agglomeration of pent as well as the pagoda, it is called the Satluj Valley style. Okay. So let's start with the most famous one, pent roof and veranda. And you could write the first example as Lakshana Devi Temple, L-A-K-S-H-N-A, Lakshana Devi Temple. It's in Bharmaur, Chamba, because that's the most famous one. And Vijli Mahadev veranda style, yes, veranda style is also there, but we are not currently, the Himachal architecture is mainly divided into these four. So we are Nagar and other veranda and the rock cut monolith. We will not going into the specific details, but that is the answer is, which you are highlighting, can be clubbed in it. And then you write the Shakti Devi temple, which is once again in pent roof category. And in Shakti Devi, you have to mention the name of Miru Varman as well. In Chamba, you can see the Miru Varman name is quite famous. Like in Kangra, we Sansar Chand ruler is famous. In Chamba, we have seen the Miru Varman. There's Mirukula Devi temple, iconic Mirukula Devi temple is also in pent roof. Suryamati had constructed it. So make sure at least few examples which we are doing, we could prepare them qualitatively. So I have highlighted in pent roof category three temples: Lakshana Devi, there is Shakti Devi, Mrikula Devi. All three have the pent roof structure. Then coming to pyramidal. Pyramidal has to be associated with Hateshwari Devi, H-A-T-E-S-H-W-A-R-I, Hateshwari Devi. Okay. And there is a Shiv temple at Thatkoti, which is also associated with this. Can you just highlight in which valley these pyramidal roof temples are mainly there? Lakshmi Devi, you have to understand, is in Chamba. Okay. Pent roof school was dominant in Chamba district. Can someone just associate pyramidal roof type? In which part district are these type of temple, pyramidal, more prominent one? Like I have mentioned, Hateshwari Devi and the Shiv temple Hatkoti. Because some of you might be from this district only. This is the most major district of Himachal Pradesh. Yes, Shimla and Sirmaur. Jyoti has answered it correctly. So make sure you could write that they are prominent in Jubbal Valley. Okay, this is in Shimla only. So you could write the Jubbal Valley and Shimla, because they might ask that this pyramidal roof style is more prominent in which district. So Shimla is the right answer, and Jubbal Valley is the specific region where you would see such temples. And yes, in pyramidal, yes, there are isolated example, but mainly this pyramidal roof has been associated with Jubbal Valley or Shimla. So if there's a specific question, then you have to pick the Shimla and the Jubbal Valley. Yes, if there are both or three, then that's another statement based question. But generally, the single fact based question are being asked, so it's always preferable to just highlight it, the Jubbal Valley. Now, in pagoda style, in bracket, you could write it's a common Kathmandu, common in Kathmandu. So this is more or less inspired from Kathmandu. If you are being to Nepal, you would see lot of temple. Lot of movies also, they show this pagoda style. So this is quite a distinct style which is there. So Hidimba temple in Manali. Okay, so this is more or less in Kullu, Manali, you would see such temple. So, and can someone just add who created this iconic temple, which ruler? Because this can be asked, because Himba architecture has already been asked, but the construction part is still not asked. So anyone who wants to associate, it's Raja Bahadur Singh. Okay, you could mention Raja Bahadur Singh. And then there is a Prashar temple. Prashar, someone can answer Prashar, because you must have covered in other theme, there's a Prashar lake as well. In which district would you associate the Prashar temple? Because that's another pagoda style, quite unique one. It's not in, because Kullu and Manali. Hateshwari Devi is pyramidal. Yes, Madhu, Hateshwari Devi is pyramidal. Yes, Arpit has once again answered. Prashar temple is in Mandi. Vikas, Arpit, all have answered. Okay, so make sure you add in pagoda style Hidimba temple, which already we had highlighted, and Prashar temple in Mandi. And this temple was built by Raja Ban Sen, B-A-N, okay, Raja Ban Sen. And finally, we have Satluj Valley style, in which you will write Dhaneshwari Devi temple. D-H-A-N-E-S-H-W-A-R-I. Dhaneshwari Devi temple. Okay, it's in Kullu district once again. And there is Bahana Mahadev in Kangra as well, which you want, if you want, you could add, because this is a quite a distinct style. Otherwise, Dhaneshwari Devi is will more or less do. And make sure, once again highlighting, it's combination of pent roof and the pagoda style. Okay. So these are the four major styles and some of the iconic temples. Make sure you just keep on adding to the list at your individual basis, because some names might not be comfortable to you, but these have to be memorized. But two or three more in each category, then you can say that you have strongly prepared this section. Okay. Now, can you just highlight the iconic, identify the site, because this is not typically in the style of roof, but nevertheless, this is the most important. A Satluj Valley style I have just drawn. I will draw it once again. Okay, when the temple starts with a pent roof, like the opening is a typical hut, but it is it also has iconic structure which is going on and on, then that club theme is called the Satluj Valley style. So that has the two themes. Yes, we have got the answers. From this is a Masroor temple, and it's in which district, can just highlight, because this is the most famous iconic landmarks, domed style, because this is is a monolith example of monolith architecture. A single rock has been cut and this has been created, and this is quite remarkable. It has survived since 8th century, and it was discovered by first time by Henry Shuttleworth. Make sure you just add this key point. Yes, this is a masrur architecture, and rock cut architecture, monolith, is the one word which you will associate, because this can be asked. It's quite a remarkable site. Where will you find the other rock cut temples? Because this is an India based culture question, because these are not common. These are just present at 3 or 4 major sites only. Can someone highlight this rock cut architecture, where it is mainly famous? Because they are at time they are even said that these are works of God, they are not from the human, because this is quite difficult art to cut at that time, that too at 8th century. Yes, the Mahabalipuram is the correct answer, in the, is famous for rock cut. Apart from that, Kailashna temple in Elephanta caves, and in Angkor Wat as well. So these iconic rock cut temples are also to be covered. Bajanath, Kangra, these themes you should also memorize. So yes, the rock cut Kangra, Ranital ke pass, and you can see that this is, there is a shikhar which is being highlighted, and there is a pond which you are seeing, because that's mandated by the temple architectures, right? There should be a sacred pond and there should be a shikhar, the roof type which you are seeing. So this is a Nagar type architecture, and not much has been known because it was discovered late, but it is dedicated to Lord Shiva mainly. There are other 8 sanctums. It remains a mysterious one, and it's quite a place to visit as well. So this is what we had to cover in the temple architecture. In embroidery part, you just have to focus on one district is quite famous. Can you name which has been there for embroidery? Which district is famous? This is a specific, like in Punjab, we say Fulkari art, because it has even earned geographical indicator tag. Is an easy one. Yes, anyone wants to give it a try. Embroidery, the needle art I am talking about. This painting one is done in needles. We use the embroidery, and typically Radha Krishna theme is being used. Yes, the easy one. The Jyoti and Arpit has answered. It's in Chamba. So Chamba Rumal is the easy theme, on which the question is likely not to be asked, because that would be a takeaway. Even the outsiders know that Chamba is famous for the embroidery part. Okay, yes, as you can see, there is a bombardment of answers. So, to conclude, let's conclude with a few of the folk dramas as well, because that's another difficult part. Generally, such questions, the match the following or the main district is associated. Yes, anyone wants to just give a short heading of folk dramas as well? We will conclude with that only. Yes, can you name any famous folk dramas? Because drama is also inherent to Himachal art and culture. Any specific name, like in Mandi, there is a quite famous one, in Chamba, and the most famous one is in Bilaspur, that's an easy one. Can you just highlight the famous folk drama? There are specific names there. Like, okay, I can start with one name, then probably you could highlight. The Swang is associated with which of the districts? Swang, S-W-A-N-G. It's quite famous one. Yes, like Jyoti has highlighted Kariala. Can you name Jyoti? Kariala is associated with which district? Yes, Kariala is with the Bilaspur, Solan, Shimla, Sirmaur. So this belt is famous for both Swang and Kariala. So let's start with these two only. Just write Kariala and Swang together. And typically Bilas, Solan, Shimla, all three districts, is it not difficult to associate them. And Nati, we all know, is even in Kullu as well. That major dance form in group dance we perform. You know, otherwise in Mandi, there is Banthara. B-A-N-T-H-A-R-A, just jot it down, because these names sometimes are not properly given in your textbooks. Banthara in Mandi, just like Johnny Gar has rightly mentioned, because this third word is written as B-A-N-T-H-A-R-A, Banthara. And then there is a Bhaktu, B-H-A-G-T-U, Bhaktu is in Kangra district, Bhaktu is in Kangra district. And anyone wants to try Chandroli? Chandroli is also another folk drama, C-H-A-N-D-R-O-L-I, Chandroli, because that district was not much in news when we were covering the temple architecture or even the paint form, but at least there is a folk drama. because apart from Kangra, in Hamirpur, this is quite prevalent. So make sure in Chandroli you mention Kangra as well as the Hamirpur. Then Jhanki, Jhanki is a easy one. Jhanki, the mask, typical, you can try, anyone wants to give it a try, the folk large masks are used in typical dance form. So Jhanki word, they associate it with. Which district is famous for Jhanki? Even the Haranther is given. Just the focus on Jhanki for this. Arpit has once again answered, it's in Chamba. Okay, so this Jhanki has to be associated with Chamba. Yes, a part of Kinnaur even, but the main district where Jhanki is being practiced is in Chamba. So make sure you just mention the first prominent name. And finally, the last we have C and Bura, S-I-H-C and Bura, because these are ballet and opera. Opera is a musical drama. Can just anyone associate with C and Bura are associated with, because this is just given in Mia Govardhan textbook. Typically, this theme is not given in Himalayan Dreamland and Wonderland. So anyone who is reading that book, C and Bura, because these are musical ballads about the various acts of separation between the lovers. Yes, in Shimla. Okay, so make sure you write the exact valley. There is the Jubbal and Rohru Valley of Shimla. Okay, just add Rohru and Jubbal Valley of Shimla. Karyala, you have to understand, is with Bilaspur, Solan, Shimla. Okay, because we have associated Swang and Karyala together. So Bilaspur is the main district where these are being prospering. So Vikas, so this is what we had for the folk dramas as well. So in today's lecture, we started with the various schools of painting, then we moved to the various museums and art galleries, and then the prominent painters, and then the temple architecture theme was discussed, and we are ending currently with the folk dramas. Okay, Bura and Sirmaur, group dance. Yes, because I have not yet covered the basic dance forms that also are to be memorized. Like the Nati dance, but that were easy ones, so it was no use in discussing that. But make sure you cover the festivals and dances forms as well. Okay. So this was all. It was good to have all of you actively participating in the answer. I hope this revision gave you some little confidence that such names can be memorized if we want, and it's just the right temperament there which we have to apply, and no theme is difficult. If you will read it with interest, there is no reason that it cannot be memorized or recalled, and once you make a sincere effort, you would see you will be in position to eliminate options. Okay, so these are the some of the qualitative themes. They will even help you in mains part as well, because this painting theme has been asked already a couple of times in last 3 years mains. So keep on adding. And the state test series, which is already going on, Jyoti, you can see that this science and environment test was conducted in the last Saturday. So that would now, currently since the institute is not able to function in physical form, but you could give the test online, the STGP 2020, it's there, and the online test will be visible on your dashboard. So make sure you can avail that facility, and even the class tests are there in your student login when you go there. There are 21 different class tests, so make keep sure you are practicing these tests. Okay. In the Telegram channel, in the description link of this video, there is a Telegram channel. There are the online test series link. So you could just click on the description link. You will see all the relevant links appear. Online courses, everything is there. Okay. So whatever is there. So and the next lecture once again would be from Abhishek sir. He had covered the economic survey part, and finally it will be the second part, which will be in on the Sunday. So make sure you don't miss that one, because the current affair question can be asked from that section. At least one or two question each lecture, we are trying to focus on one or two questions, and eventually by the end of this series we are trying to aim at least 10 to 12 questions, which are out of 20 in the Himachal Pradesh section. Okay. So once again, thank you very much, and I hope this session was useful in some way. We'll be back soon with another lecture. I'm always available. You could drop a mail at vivekrana13@gmail.com if you are facing any problems. Okay. So that's it for now. Thank you. Okay, pure 12.